All right, what's going on, everybody? So great to have you here for another episode of Mark Anthony Storm and see all your smiling faces behind the internet, behind a glass. Boop, boop, boop. So today we're going to be talking about my Walmart experience. So the day starts off pretty crappy with the gelling of the diesel fuel and the truck not running properly, but that problem was solved, so let's get to the Walmart experience. So what happens with Walmart, as always, I've mentioned before that when I go to the Walmart, many times they just take 4 hours to unload the truck. And I've never understood why it takes 4 hours to take off those pallets when other places can do it in like 30 minutes. Everything seemed okay, but then I get the alert that tells me to pick up my BOLs inside. So I head inside, and when I get to the window, the first thing that I see is some writing on my BOLs. And so the lady doesn't say anything at first. So then she just springs it on me. Boom, 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 boom. And it's like, uh-oh, what is that? And so she says, well, you are, so she says, we rejected like 8 pallets. And I'm thinking, boom, 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 boom. What? Are you kidding me? For what? So they rejected the mustard greens and the tulip greens. And they said that the reason was for 8% DK and 6% DK. And I'm thinking, boom, 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 boom. What does that even mean? Anyway, so I take the paperwork, I go back to the truck, I pull off the door. When I go inside the trailer to see what they were referencing, I find that the pallets don't even look like they were moved. Nothing had changed up to a certain point. When I go inside the trailer, it looks like the pallets had never even been touched. They were never taken off the truck. It seems more like Walmart just didn't even want to take the load off and decided to come up with any reason to just kick the load back in and that's it. But maybe the guys are tired. It's late in the morning. They want to go home, spend time with their families. Guess what? I want to do the same thing. But I know that when I have a job to do, it's get that job done. That's what I mean to do, is get it done. If you want your load to get from here to there within a certain time frame, I know it's my job to get that load to that destination on time. No excuses. Truck breaks down, throw it on your back and get there, and that's it. You understand? You with me? Can you hear me okay? Are you with me? So anyway, I'm not an inspector. I'm looking at the crates and it seemed like everything was okay. But anyway, they rejected the load. So now I was stuck with a dilemma. One, I have this gelling problem that was with the engine, but that did get resolved. Number two is, where am I going to get rid of this load? Because you can't just throw it anywhere. So I called to the fleet manager to find out, what are we going to do with this load? And the suggestion was to, bring it to a food bank. I was given a phone number to contact. I called them up, and unfortunately, the first food bank said, well, we're full. We were full before the weekend, and everything is still here because of a storm. So it's like, okay, that one's done. So then I contacted another food bank, Channel One, over in Rochester. That place wasn't even there. It just kept on going into a voicemail every time I called, and so there was no luck with that one. Then there was the one that was in St. Paul, another food bank. And so I contacted that food bank. So I was able to get in touch with a food bank in St. Paul. They told me that I can go ahead and bring the product up and they will unload it there. And then 5 minutes later, after they said it was okay, I get a call back from them saying, no, don't bring that here. We can't take it. We can't accept it. We don't have any room. Our storage is full. So I'm thinking, Jesus Christ, are you kidding me? Come on. I'm like, come on, guys, there's already 3 places that I've contacted and none of them, can take the product. So the question is, what am I going to do? I have a load that I have to pick up in the morning. What's the next step? Fortunately, my fleet manager did call me back. He let me know that the local city dump landfill would go ahead and take the product, but they were going to charge a certain amount. So we had to pay whatever that amount's going to be, but they will go ahead and take this product off the truck. But the only problem is that I have to unload it. So we're talking about 8 pallets, which is 410 cases roughly, 410 cases that I've got to take out of the trailer and dump it into a landfill all by myself. And I'm just like, wow, you know what? But it doesn't matter because I'm getting this job done. This product is not going to be stuck with me and then I lose the next load. Sometimes in trucking, not everything's going to go your way, but you know, it depends on how far and what you're willing to do to get the job done. So for me, it's just balls to the wall, do what you have to do, make it happen. Sometimes you're gonna have days that are just difficult and you just gotta roll with it. So in this case, this was one of those days. So woke up freezing to death, it was super cold, the truck didn't really wanna work, and then I get a load that gets rejected. So how many more things, you know, can go wrong, you know, in that day? But didn't matter, I was still gonna get this done one way or the other. This stuff's getting off my truck and I'm going to pick up that next load so that you guys can see what the experience was like. So I went ahead and recorded some of my experience over at the landfill so that you guys can see what it's like there. But it's really a nasty place. I mean, that place stinks. Shoot. If you think the truck stop bathrooms are bad, this place has got it beat. I mean, it was just, damn, it was, oh my God, it stunk in this. Oh my God, this landfill, it was just stinky. So, but anyway, let's go ahead and check out this clip. All right, guys, welcome back to the channel, Mark Anthony Storm. And I have to show you this because this is like really insane. Hopefully you guys can hear me clearly. This right here is a landfill. I'm going all the way downhill, okay? Going all the way downhill. Look at this, check this out. It's so pretty, isn't it? Nice and pretty, beautiful. Okay, check this out. I have to dump my load because Walmart decided they didn't want a third of what I have. And I guess, I don't know, maybe because they just didn't want to unload it. So I have to come all the way down here and dump this myself. This is going to be fun and exciting. I hate when I have to do this, but you know what? Somebody's got to do it. And I'm not keeping something on my truck. I'm not keeping this on my truck. I have something I have to pick up tomorrow. I'm not going to be late for my load, so I've got to get rid of, I think about maybe from 6 to 8 pallets are back there. And so they told me to come all the way back here to the back, and there'll be a landfill area that I'm going to dump this stuff into. It's kind of scary, and I hope I don't get trapped. But yeah, this is where I'm coming. Look at this. This is crazy. Man, all this garbage. This is nasty. The lady said there was a place to turn around. There's nothing to turn around in here. Wow. Holy crap. So guys, yeah, so that was the experience. Over at that landfill. The place was nasty. It was really, really, really nasty. But what I can tell you is that while I was unloading, I had already done about maybe 3 pallets and gotten them off the truck. But somehow, some way, out of nowhere, 2 guys showed up, you know, at the back door. 2 guys showed up at the back of the truck and were actually willing to help me dump all that stuff into the landfill. They happened to be workers that were there that were waiting to get off, but they couldn't close off the landfill while I was still there. To me, it was like having 2 angels come down from heaven and offer to help me to offload this these cases, because I mean, it's a lot of cases. 410 cases is just, it can take you many hours. I have had the experience once before, and it was actually more cases than 410, and it took me like 2.5 hours in very, very hot weather. In this situation, it was like 12 degrees outside, and you know, so I couldn't really get too hot. But God, my hands were freezing. I had gloves on, and my gloves are not waterproof, so it was just like the cold was just, you know, just starting to bite into my hands. But the only thing I could do was just, you know, grin and bear it, just hang in there. And but the end result was that I did get the product all off the truck, thanks to those two gentlemen that were willing to help. Honestly, it just seemed to be something that was like heaven sent, that maybe God just felt I was having, you know, too hard of a day, and decided to just, you know, throw two guys my way and help me out. And I am greatly grateful that that these two men did come and help me out to offload the truck. So even though you can be having a hard day in trucking, you know, somehow, some way, you know, sometimes when you're having a bad day, you know, it does work out in the end, and everything, you know, ends well. All is well that ends well is how it turned out. So I am grateful that day is over. I'm grateful to the two guys that helped me out. But tomorrow's a new day, and we're gonna go ahead and rock and roll, get the new product to its destination. So, but we're gonna just keep getting stronger by the mile. So, well, you guys have a great day. Don't forget to hit the like button. I would love for you to do that. You know how YouTube is, they're not gonna let you know. But I do greatly appreciate each one of you that comes back to the channel, and we'll see you in the next video.